Good morning, everyone. This is Dr. Shubha Bhargav from Department of Civil Engineering, SIRT Bhopal. In our series of video lectures, today we are going to discuss about the concept of the map. What exactly a map? Map is a representation of a surface, pattern, or a whole or a part of it on the plane surface, which is containing some conventional signs, and it is drawn on a particular scale and the projection. So each and every point on it corresponds to the actual position on the earth surface, right? So basically, a map is a representation of a physical features of the position or the portion particularly of the earth surface. And map making in the stone ages, map making is started a long back. In the last quarter of the 20th century, the computer replaced the cartography area, and this map is now mainly on prepared by the computer. So exactly, you can see here, this is a map of India. So in particular, in this map, you can find that it is a political map of India, in which there is some, firstly, we have mentioned the direction, the north. So we can correspond the, or we can set the direction by this sign. Okay. Then there is some certain boundaries of individual states are there. So, what mainly you can see here, a separation of a particular state to other state. So now, mainly what we can portray by the map. So just go back to the our second slide. Exactly, this is this one. What exactly a map? So we have already discussed that a map is a representation of earth pattern. Okay, so mainly what information map contain? Firstly, map contain a location and extent. Number two, characteristic of a particular feature. The particular feature which location we have provided. So the exact characteristic of particular feature, right? And we can also represent the spatial relationship of a particular feature with their respect of area, right? So mainly we will describe, or mainly three objects, or the mainly three geographic features will be discussed in this map criteria. So mainly how map is helpful for giving the location and extent. So for example, suppose you're taking a Parliament House of India. Suppose on the map, what you will find? So you have to find out first Delhi, then you have to point out the Parliament location, right? So you can easily trace out. So you already know that where is the Parliament? Parliament is at Delhi. So what you have to find? Firstly, you have to find India, then you have to find Delhi, and then you will point out the Parliament House. So this is a particular detail which provide a map on a 2D manner. Okay, then come to the next point, is characteristic. What is called characteristic? Suppose for example, you are taking road. Suppose Mahatma Gandhi road. So which type of road is this one? Is it national highway, is it a state highway, or is it service road? So what you have to find out by this study, you will find out the detail of a particular road which you have already take information about that, right? Then what is a spatial relationship? Means by which road, suppose you have taken example of Parliament House, so by which road it is connected to, and how can we reach up to Parliament House, right? So in this way, these three characters are very helpful to explain each and everything for a particular map in a 2D manner, right? Then come to the next. This is our map. Then what is the classification? Classification of map. So we have classified map into three categories. First one is a cadastral map. Second one is a topographic map. And third one is a thematic map. Right. So cadastral map, what is a cadastral map? It is always show boundaries, right? It always show boundaries. So cadastral word is derived from the French word cadastre. That means register the territories of the territorial properties. So cadastral map showing boundaries and ownership of a land. Right? And sorry, topographic map is called contour map or a topo map or a topo sheet. It's showing land contour, means of contour lines, and some water bodies, forest cover, built up areas, rail, roadways. These all type of contents will be comes under the topographic map. Then last one is a thematic map. What is exactly a thematic map? Theme-based map. Thematic means theme-based map. Thematic means it always shows some spatial pattern like relief map, geographical map, weather map, climatic map, vegetation, cultural map, political map. So thematic means some theme-based map, okay? Or it will always follow the spatial pattern according to the areas, right? And this is the major features through which we can present or we can represent our map, that is orientation. So first, we have already discussed to set a direction. Firstly, if you set a direction, you can easily set the all four direction, and you can easily understand on which part you are standing. Then scale, relation between the dimension and the map. You already know that overall area cannot be expressed in a single screen. So what we have to do? We have to reduce the scale according to our need. Then accuracy, then closeness of a measurement. Okay, so when we take up a very too much small scale, so it will make tedious to calculate the things and closeness of the, and it also affect the closeness of measurement. So always try to take up a convenient type of scales. And then resolution map. Resolution map means accuracy of feature depiction. If you will take 1 centimeter is equal to 1 inch or some other type of scale, so it will not too much feasible to understand or the calculator in a part. That's why you have to always take a convenient scale which can easily calculated or easily measured. I think this much is enough for today. We will discuss tomorrow the rest of the portion. Thank you.